Hey everybody, this is Brad from Johnson Small Engines. We are working on an X350 John Deere, and I just wanted to go over general operation on how to operate the machine. As far as getting this thing started, it's a little different than the past models because it actually has a digital readout on a dash, and when you turn it on, you're supposed to wait a few seconds until the lights all go out and start it up, and we'll just show you basically all the buttons around everything. First thing you want to do before you start your tractor is you obviously want to check the oil. This has a Kawasaki twin cylinder engine on it. And with the Kawasaki engines, the Japanese engines, you do not screw the dipstick in. We just serviced this, so it's going to be pretty clean. I put it on, I back it up a little bit just to kind of seat it, and I put in like one click there, that's it. Now it should be between the lines. This one is on the upper line, but it's almost perfect. You don't want to go above the line too much, and you don't want to have it below the bottom line. But just stick it in, kind of push it down a little bit, and pull it back out again. That's how you check it. So we're good. Make sure you got full tank of gas before you go out cutting. Okay, as far as starting it goes, you have your ignition switch up on the ignition switch here. You got your digital readout here. The yellow button on the right-hand side here is the electric PTO, which is your power takeoff for your mower deck. Then you have a parking brake lever, and then this right here is actually your cruise control. That's a nice feature to have. On the left side, you have your mower deck lift. Basically, all this does is it allows the deck to stay in the up position so you can adjust your mower deck height adjustment, which is down here. Okay, this gives you your individual units of measure, 1, 2, 3, all the way up. And then that's a backup button, that's what that is. So you have to push this down to back up while you're mowing, and that will allow you to back up without shutting the machine off. All right, so this is your throttle lever here. You have turtle and rabbit. Of course, we all know what that is, slow and fast. I usually start it, well, this is pretty much electronic, so you can start it at idle, and then you have your choke all the way up, and it's spring-loaded, so you should just be able to let it go after it starts. All right, so what you want to do is turn the key on, and we're going to show a picture of the dashboard here, and it's going to light up, and then it's eventually going to, they have a couple lights on top. One's going to be yellow and then stop. Now all this is going right now. I watch it all go. See, now as soon as all the lights go out, then you're ready to start it. Now to start this, you do have to push the parking brake on, which is on the right side, big pedal. Parking brake, push it in. You can lift your parking brake lever up, then let the brake out. Now it's on emergency brake, so you will be able to start the machine. You should just be able to crank it over and it should start right up. This particular model, I didn't even need choke. You may need choke if it's cold outside or it's been sitting in a shed. We're about 60 degrees in here. The degrees is definitely going to make a difference on how it operates and how it starts, but this is fairly new. It's only got 88 hours on it. It starts right up. So we had the parking brake on. We had it running. I just want to come over and show you the mower lift. Left foot brake is your mower deck up and down. Okay. Now to adjust the handle, we should probably lock it in the up position. So you have to push down as hard as you can and then pull this lever up and you'll hear it click. Now once that lever clicks, that mower deck is locked in the up position. So now we can come down to our lever that shows you the inches on where it's going to be set. So you can move this now to wherever you want it. All right, so you get it to where you want it. Let's just say 2 inches. Then you come back to your mower deck lift lever, push the pedal in, push the button down. Okay, and lower it down. That now is now lowered onto the number 2 adjustment. Now, if you try to adjust it now, you can't, because basically all that weight from the mower deck is sitting on your adjustment. Now, you can also cheat by just pushing the pedal in halfway, and then you can move your lever wherever you want. We're going to take it up to 2.5, let the deck down, and it's now set a little bit higher. But if you want to have the deck all the way up in the non-mow position, so you're not running over stuff, push your pedal down all the way. Lift the lever up until you hear it click, and then let go of the pedal. All right, so that's your mower lift lever adjustment right there. It's all the way up right now. We're just going to actually just like I said about the other operations here, you have the reverse. It's a reverse lockout. When you go to push your pedal in reverse, it will shut down if the mower deck is on. So if you push this button in while the mower deck is on and then you hit reverse, you will be able to back up in reverse while holding that button. All right, and that's only for reverse. This button is just for the reverse lockout. So when you're backing up without the PTO on, you don't need to push that in, but when you're backing up with your mower deck, which is the PTO, with the mower deck on, you do have to push this in while you're pushing on the reverse pedal. So come around this other side, we'll show you that we have the parking brake here, which I didn't quite go over, but push the parking brake in, and you have a parking brake button here. I just pushed it in and let it off, so now the brake pedal will come out. Now we can go forward and backward. We have forward pedal and backward pedal. The backward pedal is the one I was telling you about. If you have the PTO on and you hit this, you're gonna shut the machine down unless you are actually physically holding the yellow button in, and then you can push the yellow button in, then you can push the reverse while you're mowing, and it'll allow you to mow in reverse. We also have this is for your speed adjustment. It's actually cruise control. If you have the pedal down halfway, push this in, it'll lock the pedal down halfway. All you have to do is tap the pedal and it'll bring it back up. If you get paranoid or something, if you hit that pedal, it'll just come back up. So if you want to have it on cruise control, get your speed where you want it when you're running, push this in, let go of the pedal, then you're on cruise control. If you guys got like 3 to 5 acres of flat ground and you don't feel like holding the pedal down, this is very nice. And all you have to do is tap that pedal and it pushes it off just by tapping it, and it'll allow you to control it again. So it's very easily, you know, taken off. As far as the power takeoff I've been talking about, this yellow guy right here is what actually starts your mower deck. And normally I'll start the mower deck about half throttle, maybe 3/4 throttle, depending on the time of the year. You don't have to run this thing at full speed to start the PTO switch, because it's such a torque from the engine to the mower deck starting off at, you know, ground zero. It's a lot of torque on it. So I usually start to keep the throttle in about 3/4 position and then pull the left lever up. The mower deck will run, and then you put it all the way up to fast speed, and away you go for cutting. Now just remember, if you turn off your machine and you forget to push this button in, your machine will not turn back on again. Right now, even if I put the brake on, I cannot start my machine. It won't crank. And it's because my PTO lever is out. So you have to remember, turn that off before you get off the machine. Plus, it's a safety factor. You can't get off the machine unless this is actually pushed down, or it shuts off the machine anyway. So it's a lot of safeties involved. This is your basic operation on an X350 John Deere. Thanks for watching.